What's going on YouTube, guys? After listening to Chris Brown and Tiger's new album, Fan of a Fan, the album, guys. Now, guys, we have known in a series in a matter of 3 years, Tiger and Chris Brown have been making like mixtapes called Fan of a Fan, guys. Fan of a Fan 1, Fan of a Fan 2. I don't know. I'm not sure if that was a third one. But guys, this is the album. And guys, this, what a surprise, guys. I would just love to say, as a lyrical beast, Chris Brown has really came up, guys. He showed on really on this album that he can rap and sing, guys. I applaud Chris Brown and Tiger as well, because Tiger is also a good rapper as well. But guys, Chris Brown has really showed a dramatic and a very, very, very lyrical skill of his rapping, guys. Now, he showed that he can really rap. So let's get into this album. Get into it, guys. Get into this. Get into this. Okay?
Don't get it fucked up. Do this shit for my loved ones.
Don't get it fucked. Yeah, you can sing your girlfriends. I wanna see.
Majority of these songs on this album is nasty. Is nasty as hell. But guys, we is about to get into this shit right here. Guys, we got the first song, which is West Side. Guys, I was just definitely feeling the beat and the intensity and the lyrics of this song, guys. Like, they really jacked off on this album, guys. West Side is just probably my favorite song. It's the first song on the album, guys. It's very soothing start. It starts off very soothing and then it goes to like a little cool little beat. It kind of got a little Michael Jackson type flow to it, the way Chris Brown is singing. And then boy, but when he started rapping, oh my God. Like, he's just really killing them damn vocals and them lyrics, guys. And Tiger is just filling in, guys. They are an amazing duo, guys. Like, they should do albums all the time together, guys. This is probably one of Chris Brown and Tiger's best album, guys. Now, see, when they did their mixtapes, it was cool, but I really like the album because it just really showed, like, I just like every song, guys. I'm just say I give it a 10 out of 10. But anyway, let's get to the second song. The second song is indeed a song by DJ Mustard.
So I switch from a Benz to a Range. First class to the jet. Yeah. Ain't nothing like me, girl.
Nothing Like Me, guys. Okay, I like the song, but guys, DJ Mustard is gonna have to switch up his beats, guys. I'm just tell y'all this. Okay, he did like maybe like 4 or 5 songs on this album, and guys, all his stuff sound the same to me. Okay, now this is no shade at all, but guys, I just would like to see DJ Mustard, you know, just switch it up just a little bit, because all of his stuff is starting to sound the same. This sounds a little like Loyal. This sounds a little like, what's the name of that song he did with Kid Ink, guys? Oh my God. Most of the majority of DJ Mustard's songs sound alike, and I would like for him to switch it, but I like the song, okay? This, featuring T.Y. Dolla $ign, guys, and he, you know, his verse was cool, and Tiger had a nice little verse, and Chris Brown did his little spitting, you know, he pretty much rapping on all the songs, guys, which I applaud Chris Brown on. But anyway, let's get into Ayo. Okay, that song was just okay to me, guys. Okay, I at first wasn't feeling it, but guys, when I think about the album and the songs of this album, I would say that this album, it really fits this album, but the song was just okay. Then we had number 4, Girl You Loud. This is just my shit. Okay, I just like the beat. I just like the way that Chris Brown and Tiger is spitting on this shit, y'all. They is going the fuck off. Okay, they are serving with these lyrics. Guys, I just love the beat. I just like the way this shit just knocks. It comes in and just make you want to ass a little turn up. Kind of, y'all, I just like it. They talking about smoking weed. They talking about, you know, eating out. And that just kind of a little nasty on this one. Guys, they look nasty on all these songs. But anyway, I like Girl You Loud. That's probably one of my first favorites on this album. Then we have Remember Me. Okay, guys, now I've heard the song, and I like the song, guys. It sounds like a nice R&B song, guys. I just really would like it if they didn't curse so much on the R&B songs, guys, because, you know, they got a little mixture of turn-up songs, club joints, and R&B songs, and they curse way too much. But, guys, I just really like the song, guys. It's very nice. Then we got I Bet featuring my nigga 50 Cent. Okay, guys, now this probably could have been a DJ Mustard song. If it ain't DJ Mustard, it sounds like him. Okay, I like the words to the songs, you know, and I like the title, and the song is nice, but guys, the beat just kind of sounds a little like, I don't know, Ayo and Nothing Like Me and Loyal. But guys, I liked it. Then we got, oh my God, number 7. I just love this song. Don't Get It Fucked Up, guys. I just can't deal with the Slage. This is an old school 90s sounding, the way that the beat sounds. It kind of sounds a little like Bone Thugs and Harmony. And I like Pusha T. I liked his verse. You know, he was doing his thing on there, and it was just Chris Brown really snapped. I like when he put Eminem, a verse off of Eminem's song "Don't Forget About Dre." Guys, it was kind of like a remix to "Don't Forget About Dre," guys. And I just like it, guys. It was amazing. Better. Now, see, they sampled Take Our Time from TLC, guys, and I loved it. I like how they did it. It was just epic, guys, and I liked the way how Chris Brown was singing on it, and he was rapping on it as well, guys. I'm really feeling, we already know Tiger can rap, but guys, Chris Brown really showed that he can rap his ass off on this album. I applaud him for that, because it's amazing, guys. This is probably a good step for Chris Brown as far as rapping. Because, guys, I always looked at him as a singer. But then, anyway, we got Lights Out. This is just a regular smooth Chris Brown joint, guys. And he's serving with them vocals, the high notes, guys. He is just going in. And Tiger is just putting his, you know, his two cents in the song. And I like how they back each other up with what they're saying with these nasty ass songs. But guys, then we got Real One. There was something very club about this, and it's also featuring Boozy Badass. And guys, I like the beat. It sounds very urban, kind of old school urban a little bit, guys, and I like it. Boozy Badass did his thing, and I liked it. Bitches and Marijuana. This is strictly a turn-up song, guys. I will be in the club and just add to this shit, because this song will get you out your seat. It will keep you moving, and I just wish that they didn't curse so much on these songs. But anyway, then we got She Going Up, which is 12, which is the official of the standard version of the album, guys. She Going Up. I was definitely feeling it. It had a nice little smooth sound to it, guys, and it was different. Yeah. Even though I think it was the DJ Mustard, it still, you know, had its points. Now usually I don't do this, but a nigga wanna trip, so I'ma take a nigga bitch. Ooh. Now see, I'm gonna tell you something, how they is. They are very bold with these words on this damn album. And that's one thing I like about this album, guys. They are very outspoken, you know, normally than usually. They are very outspoken with this album and with these songs, and I like it. Guys, then we get Wrong and the Right Way, guys. Something about that title is catchy, and I'm gonna do something to you in the wrong and the right way or something. And I like it, guys. It's very smooth. I can just rock to it. It gets kind of jazzy. It's kind of old school. And I like it, guys. Then we got 14 Bunkin featuring J305. I don't think I know who that is. Then we got T.I. This is definitely had a T.I. flow on there, guys. T.I. had the best verse as far as the feature on this song, guys. And I liked it. And it was amazing, guys. The beat is just nice, and it was popping. It was popping. It was cut. Then we got It's Your Shit featuring Wale. Do I necessarily agree if Wale should have been on this song? Guys, I'm not the biggest Wale fan like I used to be, guys. But guys, I don't think Wale should have been on the song at all. I think it should have been just for Tiger and Chris Brown, because Wale sometimes go left field. And I just thought that his verse was just okay. But, you know, it was just a little, you know, it just, it, he could just. But anyway, it is what it is. I like the song. Then we got Banjo. I'ma beat the pussy up like it's a banjo. Child. These niggas got some nasty ass mouths and they need to be washed out with soap, okay? Okay, cursing all on these damn songs. But anyway, I liked it. It was different. I don't know if this was. It kind of sounded a little like DJ Mustard as well, which was cool, guys, because, you know, everybody's feeling his vibe and his style. But, guys, like I said, I was just like him to change it up a bit. But anyway, guys, I would love to applaud. This is a very great album, and I really like the album cover because it looks very old school, retro, kind of like 90s flow, a little bit crisscross kind of. It looks very it's kind of got, I like the little gold, red and blue colors. I like the little stripes around they, you know, around them. And I like with Chris Brown, and I don't know, it look like he growing out. I don't know if this nigga trying to get dreads, oh lord, but he got his twisties in, and he don't really look the same. And Tiger just got his face like this. But guys, I like the album cover. It's amazing. But guys, this is a very good album. I recommend you buying it on iTunes, guys. Please check it out. Please give me your comments and tell me what you think about the album. If they did a good job. If you thought some of the songs were sounding too much alike. If you thought that DJ Mustard should switch up his zhush a little bit. Guys, just give me your thoughts and your honest opinion about this album, guys. And this is Forever Brandon TV signing off.